Event lighting battery parcans use wireless DMX instead of physical cables to connect together. This video will show you how to connect them together in a master-slave configuration through wireless DMX. To pair two or more devices in a master-slave configuration, the master needs to be set as the transmitter and the slave or slaves need to be set as the receiver. The first step is to ensure the wireless mode is enabled on all devices. To do this, switch on each device, and if the wireless DMX LED is on, wireless mode is enabled. If it is not, you will need to enable it before you are able to set up the master-slave configuration. Use the menu button to cycle through to the radio settings, which will read as RF off. Using the up or down key, change it to RF on. Press enter to confirm. The wireless DMX LED should now be on. Now that wireless mode is enabled on all devices, the next step is to select the mode or program on the master device. In this example, we will use auto program. Likewise, use the buttons to cycle to the mode or program you need. As receivers, all slave devices will need to be on DMX mode. To do this, cycle through using the menu button until you see D001. If it is any other number, use the up-down buttons to change it to D001. Press enter to confirm the DMX mode. Ensure this is done on every single slave device. Now we will set the master as the DMX transmitter and any slave devices as the DMX receivers. To set the master as a transmitter, power off the device. Press and hold the DMX select button and power on the device again. The wireless DMX LED will be white once it is powered on. Use the button to cycle through the different DMX modes. Please refer to the manual for mode definitions. For the master to be used as a transmitter, cycle through until you see blue. Then press and hold the DMX select button until the LED turns white to confirm. It will then turn to a solid blue. The device is now in the transmitter mode and ready to pair with other slave devices. The next steps need to be done on every slave device. Power off the slave device, then power it on while holding the DMX select button. This time, cycle through until you see green, as this is the receiver mode. Then press and hold the DMX select button until the LED turns white to confirm. If the LED flashes red, it means it is already paired with another transmitter but cannot find it. To unpair the device, press and hold the DMX select button until the LED turns white. On the master device, press the DMX select button once and all wireless DMX LEDs will begin to flash. When they are successfully paired, they will become solid blue and green again. As the auto program is already running in this example, you can see that the slave is now also synchronized with the master device. Once the devices are paired, even after powering off, they will remember the configuration when powered back on again.